Hey guys, Gabriel Nassif for channelfireball.com, and I'm pretty excited today because I'm going to be recording my first draft for Channel Fireball. Hopefully I don't embarrass myself. I've been doing okay in the format, not great, but you know, decent. I've got about 65% win rate, tying it under 55%, I think. I played 50 drafts, got 14 trophies, which is, you know, good, not great. All in the single limbs draft. I'm gonna just fire single limb. Hopefully I don't lose round one, or, you know, hopefully if I lose round one, it's at least an interesting match. If, you know, maybe if the game sucks, I just record another one, but I'd rather just keep playing competitive leagues. I heard the difference, level difference, not huge, but yeah. And before I fire, I'll tell you a bit about what I've been drafting. I've mostly been drafting, I think, pirates. I think I draft an abnormal amount of pirates, which probably means I have leaks in some of my picks. I've definitely had my train wrecks when your lane is not open, or the decks are weird sometimes. Sometimes you think a tribe is open, and then you think it's not, but it really was, and the packs were just, a bit weird. It's kind of tough. I heard a lot of people hating on the draft format. I think it's kind of interesting. I'm 50 drafts in, and I still really haven't figured out how to, you know, avoid those train wrecks, and I haven't figured out when you're supposed to, you know, stick it out, kind of, and even if you feel you're not in the perfect tribe, things are going to be good enough and it's not worth switching. I feel like this format is deceptively tough. People are like, oh, you just pick two colors and then it's tribal. But, you know, I think if you want to maximize your chances of winning, knowing when to switch, and even like first pick, first facts, I mean, there's still some tough decisions sometimes. I had to pick the other day between Vona the Butcher, which is an insane rare, and Charging Monstrosaur. I wasn't sure. I ended up taking Vona. I think I was right, but Monstrosaur leaves you open to every color combination. Vona is very splashable if you're blue. Maybe that's not the best example, but and on specific cards too, I've been pretty low on the auras in general. I think Swashbuckling is borderline unplayable. I don't love Mark of the Vamp, and a lot of people do. I know when I stream, people yell at me whenever I don't pick a Cutlass. Cutlass has been kind of medium for me, but I've seen Cutlass be good for others, or other, a lot of people who do well pick it pretty high, so, you know. But yeah, hopefully we have interesting, decisions. Hopefully I just don't open the knotted rare and just have an easy draft. And let's see how things go. Seven in the queue. Same for archetypes. A lot of people think Merfolk is great, but I've been struggling a bit with Merfolk. Maybe I draft the archetype poorly. It's not easy. I definitely have a bias towards pirates, maybe just because I'm comfortable with pirates. And I feel like, also it makes sense, it's 3 out of 10 archetypes are pirates, so statistically you're going to be pirates, or you should probably end up pirates more often than Vamp or Merfolk, unless you're forcing. I think people have more or less figured out Dino, like especially white greens, not the best, but I've had some okay, maybe people haven't figured out how to draft the white green archetype exactly, or maybe you're supposed to, you know, there's the blue-white archetype. Nico Boni wrote an article about how he thought blue-white was one of the best archetypes. I've had it a few times and I've had some okay decks, but I usually end up in those colors when things aren't going right and you know, try and salvage. I haven't looked to draft blue white, so yeah. Well, I'm gonna take the Monster Zor. Obviously, if Monster Zor wasn't in the pack, I think I'd have a somewhat close pick between Branchwalker and Contract Killing. I would probably take Contract Killing, but I could see it be a mistake. Like premium 2 drop, Contract Killing is great removal spell. Maybe the best black common, Vanquish the Weak is strong, Skullduggery can be good if you're aggressive. You know, I feel like the next time I draft, if I get the choice between Branchwalker and Contract Killing, I'll just go with the Branchwalker. Just, I'm at the point, you know, after 50 drafts where I'm pretty comfortable, you know, drafting most archetypes, or, you know, anyways, the black archetypes, and I think I would just take Branchwalker here just to see how things go. Alright, so Monster Azure leaves us pretty open. So the next best card was, there was Branchwalker and Contract Killing. Those two cards should go next. So we've got Direfleet Captain, which is this guy. Yeah, I probably shouldn't have my webcam on the pack. I'm gonna move that. Alright. So Direfleet Captain, really good 2-drop, best red card in the pack is Surestrike. Surestrike has impressed me a lot. At first it just looks like, you know, decent trick, but card's really strong, kills Carnage Tyrant on the reg. I really like the card. I could take, you know, if I'm looking to branch out, I could take Runaground. I could take the green card to be Red Green Dino, Direfleet Captain, Surestrike. It's a close pick. I think I'm gonna go with Captain. I think the card is good enough that I can quote unquote gamble on the second color. Surestrike's really good, but it's a common you might see more in the draft, and it's not like it's irreplaceable. Good 2-drops are pretty hard to come by. But yeah, I'm not sure. Maybe Surestrike's a pick. I feel like it's a close pick. I could have also taken the green 2-drop, I guess. It's pretty bad, but, you know, red, green, dino, maybe a thing. I don't think the green 2-drop was up there. Here, kind of a tough pick. I have the knight, which is kind of the safe pick because I really want to play Monster Zor and, you know, maybe potentially going to white-red if black is kind of cut. Also cutting red, I guess, is a thing. Maybe I should have just taken the Surestrike. Or I could take the Seeker Squire, which is probably the better 2-drop between... This is not a tough pick. I'm just going to go back to knight, but that makes me feel bad about the Surestrike pick. Knight is okay in red-black, though, because you want to be aggressive a lot of the time when you're red-black, and you don't mind playing, you know, Raptor, the 4-2 Raptor, so you're gonna have some dragons. Here, I have kind of an interesting pick. I would almost always pick Fire Cannon Blast. Well, I would have until now, but I feel like good 2-drops are just so important in the format. I was thinking about starting picking good 2-drops over Fire Cannon Blast. This is kind of an interesting draft so far. Besides the first pick was straightforward. This is a super close pick. I think I'm just still gonna take Fire Cannon Blast. The captain tables sometimes. I might not end up black. And I'm not sure picking premium 2-drops is really better than picking premium removal. Fire Cannon Blast is a premium removal. If it had an unfriendly fire is not premium. You get fives. You have the Arsonist, who's in the 4-4 uncommon guy who goes late. You have Pyromancer, that's acceptable at five. But yeah, Fire Cannon Blast. You know, kill Air Elementals, kill some 6-6 dinos. Pretty easy knight here. I might really end up regretting that short strike pick. Kind of an interesting pick. I think, given my deck so far, Interloper, you know, if I end up red-black, there's a chance I'm going to regret not having an Interloper, but I'm just going to stick to red and take the Unfriendly Fire. And we've got a super late looter. And a raptor to go with my two knights. This is a super tough pick. Because ideally with two knights now, I want to be white-red. I didn't see a lot of white though. Looter is kind of busted though. It's a really, really strong card. I kind of want to take Raptor. Kind of want to just take... With two knights, you really want to be red-green or white-red. I feel like it's pretty big. I'm just going to take Raptor. This could be a pretty bad pick. And I was going to say that's a sure strike, but no, that's not the pack I opened. We already have seven picks in, so... Super happy to pick up the sure strike. Speaking of white-red dino, I don't think that card's playable. Even if you're white-red, like, it's not even that good. Seven mana. I think Fire Shrine Keeper's pretty bad. I think Field of Ruins is an okay sideboard card. Double Strike when Ceratops... Yeah, this card is just not playable, but it might be a signal. Maybe it's the guy to my left will be like... I don't know. Yes, I'll take Fire Shrine Keeper. Really, you really hope not to have to play the card. That's pretty late Fathom Fleet Cutthroat. I think the card is very solid. I feel like a lot of the time it goes later than it should. And a couple of Venom cards left in the pack. Pyromancer makes me feel good about red. If I end up red-black, I already have three solid 2-drops. The Vamp is really mediocre. Pyromancer is not great. But I'm gonna just take it because I might not be black. That's a really late mark of the Vamp. I'm not a big fan of auras, but you know, it's still a good card. Take Castaways, I usually don't play this card, but you know, I don't think, what is the other card? Swashbuckling, I hate with a passion. I think you only play Swashbuckling if your deck's really bad. Might be good in bad decks. And yeah, Castaway. Might be good if I get like, who knows, you know, if I get a bunch of cheap pirates and a couple of cutlasses or other artifacts. Another kind of tough pick. Melody's really, really strong. I think it's much better than Contract Culling, but... I do have, you know, two very solid cards, the two pirates, and then two potential, and Contract Clang is still good. I didn't see blue at all in the first pack, and I passed that late looter, so I feel like kind of committed to red-black at this point, and I think I'm just going to take Contract Killing. Plus, I passed the late looter. I didn't see much blue. Did I pass blue early in the first pack? I didn't pass any... I passed some random blue pirates, like the looter, etc. I think I'm just going to take Contract Killing. The Dire Fleet Captain did not table, so that's somewhat scary. I think I'm just going to take the Pirate 2-drop. The Dreadnought's decent if you don't have vibes. As I said, I like the Cutthroat. Pillage I've tried playing once. It was pretty medium. Pretty mediocre. Could be okay, I guess. I'm just going to take the 2-drop. And... I kind of like Raider's Wake. I sure seem to be losing to the card a lot. enchantment. Whenever an opponent discards a card, that player loses 2 life. So basically, it has raid. You attack, raid, at the end of turn, they discard and they take 2. I could take another knight and hope to pick up more raptors later in the pack. Or, you know, other red dinos. See, this is where I struggle a bit. I don't know if I'm supposed to pick knight, if I'm supposed to pick the Deadeye Tormentor. I think he's kind of mediocre. If I'm supposed to take Raider. You know, when you have those, like, you know, red-black, you want to be pirates, right? But sometimes the pack break out in a way that you don't get the nut, you know? You don't just get hooked up with all pirate guys and all removals. And then, you know, it's easy life. Pretty bad pack. If this was a Magic Online, if I were at the PT, I might be tempted to just hate the Herald. I think the card's busted. And I don't love the Queen Base Soldier. I don't have any tricks so far, I just have the one Sure Strike. I don't have any Skullduggeries. I think it's a pretty bad 2-drop. But I really don't have that many options. Heartless Pillage. Not terrible with my curve. I have a bunch of 5s. Maybe I'll give the Pillage another shot. Packs are pretty mediocre. Damn, I'm just going to take Dual Shot. Feels like a good sideboard card, but the last couple times I've brought it in, I've regretted bringing it in. So the card's been kind of bad for me. And that was kind of the risk going into black. And that's where I think maybe the Dire Fleet Captain pick was bad, because I passed that contract killing. I mean, someone to your left is going to be black. If it's not the next guy, it's going to be like in 2 or 3 seats, you know, to your left. But not like the pack has awesome cards in other colors, but still kind of feels bad. I'll take the Looter, I guess. Mystic still in the pack. Always makes you cringe, late Mystic. I don't hate this guy if you have the tricks to push through. Probably not that good in my deck. I think I'm gonna take Duress. This could be a Swashbuckling deck. 1-drop Swashbuckling. I'm gonna take Mark of the Vamp. Pretty late Deadeye Tormentor. Siren's Roost still in the pack. I love this card in the right deck. And yeah, this guy gets no respect. I think he's very solid. And we even table Raider's Wake. Wow, and Herald of the Stream still in the pack. How many 2-drops do I have? 5? I mean, I guess no one is Merfolk at the table, so I probably wouldn't even counter-draft it, even at the PT at this point, because they didn't take it the first time around. Wow, Captivating Crew. This pack is... I wish I could just take free cards and be done. Rigging Runner, I love. I think it's very good. I'm not sure if it's better than the red 2-drop, the Firebrand, the one you can pump for red and 1. I'd probably still take the 2-drop, but Trigging Runner is really strong. First Strike, 2-2 First Strike is really strong in the format. Lots of 2 toughness guys. Blocks really well. Scoundrel's really strong too. But Captivating Crew, I've never had the rare, but I heard it's busted. I've had it played against me once or twice. Things didn't go on. And it's a pirate. Have you, like, usually those busted rares have a weird type? This guy's pirate on top of everything. Vanquished the weak. Pretty easy pick here. The brute. Another easy pick, given my curve. The knight's looking kind of silly, but there's still, you know, bears was a small upside. I love the brute. Skullduggery, easy pick. Another late looter. Yeah, can't help but think that Dire Fleet Captain pick was wrong. Looks like my deck's still gonna be great, but it, I mean, Sure Strike has been really good for me. Not sure you can justify second picking Sure Strike just in your colors though. Not our brutes. I'll take as many brutes as I get, I guess. Pretty good was Mark of the Vamp. One of the problems with Mark of the Vamp is a lot of the time you have to, you know, you only have two toughness guys, and having a four toughness guy, if it doesn't have evasion, pretty easy to block. Wow. Just wow. Those cards are all... Once I'm red black, I wouldn't be unhappy first picking any of those cards. I'm gonna take the two drop, or one of the two drops. Have 30 playable cards, no, a lot of bad ones. Let's see, 20 seconds left. I think I'm gonna take the Freebooter. I haven't played with the card much. I think it's pretty strong. I love the Firebrand. Love, love him, but wow, another one. Wow, maybe I was in the right colors, but still, I mean, still doesn't necessarily justify, we're talking about the second pick captain, but... Wow. Firebrand, the Raptor is good in my deck, I do have triple knight. Maybe I just don't end up playing the knight. Maybe I'm just gonna take the Firebrand. Skullduggery is also really strong. My Rigging Runner just stable, no big. All right, I feel like, and that's what I kind of hate about leagues, is sometimes I feel like those cards wouldn't be in the pack if people were counter drafting more when they don't have anything good for their deck. Or maybe the packs were just busted. Maybe the packs were just really strong. Might take the four drop for the curve or Unfriendly Fire. I tend to just put creatures at a premium, especially recently, you know, and when I say recently, I mean past few years or more than that even, they seem to make removal pretty crappy and creatures fairly strong. Also, it's, you know, with four brutes or three brutes, make sure I have another pirate in play. It's actually quite relevant a lot of the time. So yeah, I'm not gonna have an easy time in deck building. Let's see, group separately. Definitely not playing Queen's Bay Soldier. Seven two drops, maybe one too many. Probably end up cutting some knights. The knights pick were definitely kind of a hedge, you know. They're not terrible in red black, not ideal usually, and if white is open, they're kind of the nuts in white-red, also in red-green, so I don't remember exactly what I took the nights over, but yeah, it'd be interesting to go back. I really regret taking, you know, maybe I end up in red black anyways, but I think maybe I should have just taken Sure Strike over Captain. I've played three Sure Strikes before and been happy. I actually had a deck recently where I had my only non-creature spell was were Sure Strikes, and I think I lost round one. I think my deck was good though. I think I lost a close match. I can't remember. Maybe I won the draft. I doubt it though. All right, that's lots of playables. 28. All right. I don't feel like I have the best Raider's Wake deck. It's pretty good in Vamp when you can just send tokens. I guess it's decent with the Brute. Definitely playing those six spells. So that's pretty easy. And I have too many guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Probably can cut a knight. I don't think I want to cut any of those guys. And I probably have to cut a 4-drop. Interloper loses a bit of value when you don't have 5 or 6 drops or mana sinks. You don't need the land as bad. I'm just gonna cut Interloper. I could maybe cut both Interlopers. Having a lot of Menace Guy, they get better. The more Menace Guys you have, the harder it makes it for them to block. Mark of the Vamp is tempting, especially with the Freebooter. I get to see their hand. Pretty good on a Brute. I feel the difference between, you know, especially on the Menace Guy, between 4 toughness and 5 toughness is pretty big. All right, that's 23 right now. Let's see. I could potentially play 16 lands. I think I have just too many 5 to play 17. I could maybe cut. Unfriendly Fire is probably too good to cut. Could cut. Add a couple of cheap drops. Raider's Wake is interesting too. Maybe as a sideboard card. As I said, I think it's a bit better in Vamp. It's been good against me recently, but I feel like it's been good mostly when I've been a bit mana screwed. It does make sure it's really hard for you to come back from a mana screw though. All right, I don't think I'm gonna play the Tormentor. I'm still not sure how I feel about the Pyromancer. Seems pretty good with Brood though, is all my Broods. Yeah, I'll play 17, I have the Captivating Crew, so I guess I kind of have a mana sink. All right, 23, looks pretty good. Could cut Interloper for a cheaper card. or for one of, you know, Raiders Wake, Mark of the Vamp. Wouldn't hate a knight. Maybe I'll just play the knight anyways. Maybe just smooth out my curve. Maybe add a 2-drop, remove Pyromancer, and add a 4. Either Raider's Wake. I'll play one Interloper. Alright. Modo suggests 10-7. I think I'm gonna go 9-8. And yeah, so that's it for the draft and the deck building. And I'll see you in a second for round one. Alright, round one. We won the die roll. Pretty important was our deck. And very good draw. Just swap the Unfriendly Fire for a Monstrous Ore. And I probably have my nut draw. Or something like a Skullduggery, maybe. Got paired against Merfolk. We're actually fine during the Rigging Runner. I think it was Ben Stark who... He was the first one I saw talking about the card, how you pretty much never want to play it on turn one. It's... You just play it on... Ideally go 2-drop, and then on turn 3 go 2-drop Rigging Runner as a 2-2. Play Raptor. Not sure how I feel about Jungle Denver. I thought it was kind of unplayable at first. And the first 2 or 3 times I saw someone play it against me, they never got to put a counter on it. I've heard people say it's actually okay in you know, the Merfolk decks. But as I said, I haven't had much success with Merfolk. I think I've only drafted Merfolk 4 or 5 times out of 50 drafts, which is, I guess, you know, 1 in 10. And I think I've had a 3-0 once. But I think I had Tishana and Overflowing Insight. That's, yeah, it's looking pretty desperate already. His play. Those plays, you better have a really strong follow-up. Something like Jaded Guardian into One Was the Wind. Because if you just go down on cards like that early on in the game, that's pretty risky. And yeah, One Was the Wind. People obsessed to was One Was the Wind. They're like 1-drop into One Was the Wind game, you know, and I honestly, I don't really get it. People play removal, people play bounce spells, people can, you know, sometimes people just hit harder. So let's see. I have kind of a tough decision here. Card I'm worried about is Dive Down. It's a blue instant, +0/+3 hexproof. So if I Fire Cannon Blast the Keeper and he has it, it's just a disaster because now he has a 2/5 that took no damage. He can block my whole team. But if I attack, I lose my Raptor. I mean, I'm just gonna attack. I only get blown out by Dive Down. I think he's down to 2 cards. My hand is stacked. And this way I just get to blast the Delver. You know, if he has dive down, I can still kill it next turn. All right, he didn't have Dive Down. You know, if I knew he didn't have Dive Down, I would just Fire Cannon, blast the 2/2 before damage, and put him down to 5, And I said I have unfriendly fire in hand. But yeah, alright. Well, this game was just... I guess it's not completely over yet, actually. If he has another solid, you know, if he just plays a big guy next turn, I might struggle to finish him off. He needs a Whiptail. Jadian Guardian would be good too. All right, nothing. That was close though. I mean, we both had pretty recent. I mean, my draw was very good. His draw was very good as well, I guess. The rest, he showed one was the win and +2/+2. I don't think it's enough to bring in the rest. I do have a couple of removal spells for his cards. Mark was the Mark of the Vamp against blue. You know, bounce spell is always sketchy. Definitely not bringing in Raider's Wake on the draw against an aggressive deck. Tormentor, still pretty weak. Dual Shot. He did play one toughness into one toughness. I feel like even when I see those cards, every time I bring in Dual Shot, I end up regretting it. Pyromancer is slow. It is a lot about tracing. So Mark of the Vamp, even against blue cards, you know, against one was the win, is kind of tempting. What would be a bad card against him? I don't really have bad cards. Because Depths of Desire, let's say I go Headstrong Brute into Mark of the Vamp, tag for 5, it's still a 10 life swing, so even if he bounces my guy, it's still a 1-for-1. I lost tempo, but the tempo I lost is kind of made up by the fact that I gained 5, so it's not the end of the world. Especially on the draw, I feel like maybe I need the life swing at some point if he has a crazy aggressive draw. I'm gonna bring it in. Even though he's playing blue. You know, in grindier matchups, if the opponent has a lot of removal, you don't want it. But I feel that's a matchup where you might want the life swing. And I think I'm gonna board out Interloper. That makes sense. Could also board out a 2-drop. Alright, he mulliganed. Hand is slow. I don't think I can mulligan. I have 2 draw steps to draw a 2-drop. 3 draw steps to draw a 3-drop, etc. Oh, beautiful. What a beautiful Direfleet Hoarder. Alright, he has a solid start. He scryed to the top. Let's see if he can get there. Was one was the wind. This is not looking great for me. I'm gonna lie. If I had the Brute, I guess Dual Shot is actually pretty good in my deck. I forgot I had the two Cutthroats. That's a combo. Maybe I should have the... Yeah, I'm not sure how I win this game. It's kind of funny. I've been shit-talking the auras non-stop. I mean, one was the one I don't hate. I'd rather not have to play it, but I guess in Merfolk it's pretty standard to play one was the wind. Swashbuckling I really despise. I feel like I'm, you know, maybe 80% win against people who have played Swashbuckling against me. Alright, I'm drawing dead to Fire Cannon Blast, I guess. Can put him down to 4. Yeah. Can I sack it? Gain control of duration, open control on time that creature. It gains haste until end of turn. I guess I'll attack. Maybe he'd do something really dumb, like... I don't even know. Alright, I'm gonna steal it. Like, I have maybe Costly Plunder or something. At least get him to show me if he has Dive Down in his deck. Alright, he has Dive Down. Good to know. Remembering Dual Shot. I don't think I need Mark of the Vamp on the play. Could bring in the rest. The rest has been kind of poor for me. The rest has been really poor for me. Not really poor, but I think when I'm the I can just race his good draws. If I have a good draw. Maybe I'm just, you know, maybe I'm approaching the wrong way. Maybe I'm just supposed to bring in two the rest, two Mark was the Vamp, and play my deck this way. I guess that's not really how I play, how I build my decks. Because then you lose to the normal draw or your Duress breaks and your Mark of the Vamp, they have a bounce spell and you don't have Duress, you know, just everything goes wrong. Pretty unfortunate, no 2-drop. I can't even say I like skimped on the 2-drops. I guess I have a base soldier in my sideboard. That's why people insist on curve and 2-drops. It makes so much difference. Not having a 2-drop here is potentially a, you know, 10 life swing or something. So play Captivating Crew, give mana to my Brute. I'm surprised he didn't leave his sailor back. Alright, let's see. Not too many options, right? Pounce. Wow. Clutch Skullduggery. Alright, so I'm gonna pump him 5-4. I guess I just minus the Sailor. That was a decent Skullduggery. The good old 3-4-1 Skullduggery. Jeez. Wow. See, and that's kind of what I mean when you're playing cards like One for the Wind. You know, it forces you to play the game one way. Which, personally, I kind of hate when I have to do that. Forces you to play the game one way, one dimensional, leaves you with no options beside beat all in, because you have those kind of, you know, half cards. I mean, sometimes you steal games, like in game two, so it's, you know, I could be wrong, or, you know, it's not like all downside and you should never do it. Or maybe I'm just too old school, you know. Just auras are bad. Auras were notoriously bad forever, you know. Especially in limited. It was like, well, he's playing auras, he's bad at magic. So I don't know if we were bad, or, you know, we haven't figured it all out, or if there were auras were worse. There were some good auras. There was the uncommon, I think it was in Urza's block, the uncommon. There was one that made your guy, you know, Shivan Dragon +2/+2 flying and fire breathing. There was the one that gave it +3/+3 trample or something. The blue one was +2/+2 flying shroud. The white one was a Sarah Angel. Those ones were pretty busted, but you know. Anyways, round of match win, that's good. And yeah, I'm gonna fire the second match and I'll see you in a sec. Alright, round two. I won the die roll because, you know, I feel like I win the die roll a lot. I need to start keeping track. I say that every time. Bias, result oriented, etc. Strong hand, good curve, trick, perfect trick when you're attacking. Potentially really good was the Brute too. They finally get that double block and you just have the sure strike. Can't count the number of times I've told myself if they have sure strike, I'm just gonna get wrecked. And sad part is they usually do have the sure strike. Wow. I was gonna say this knight looking pretty sad against the shorekeeper, but then I just draw my one raptor. Blessed. That's the one archetype I haven't got a chance to draft more, and I feel it's pretty strong, is white red, you know, Dino, more or less. Like, perfect old two-drop knights, and then old hammer skulls or whatnot. Alright, his deck looks pretty bad. I don't know who Moto paired me against. He probably just has Hostage Shaker in his deck, because Shorekeeper into River Sneak when you're blue-black is pretty atrocious. No, it's... Knight looks even more likely. Yes, yeah, so I was half joking with Hostage Shaker, but now it looks like he's actually playing blue-green, splashing black. There's not many cards you splash black for when you're blue-green. It's really hard to splash in Merfolk. So now I'm legit worried. I don't have a removal spell. Oh well, we'll see, I guess. Please no Hostage Taker. Did he keep on top with Opt? Oh god, he topped. And you just chum blocking. Alright. You know, if he starts chum blocking, he has 2-1-1 in play. Maybe I can just beat a Hostage Taker. Yeah, spell is a spell. Gonna keep. Can play 2 spells next turn. Potentially 2 spells a turn after that. Alright, no hostage taker. I'm just going to play the freebooter before attacking. I have the sure strikes, I'm really not worried about much, but... Wow. Hey, what? Didn't he top with Opt? Did he top the Deep Root Champion? Oh, maybe he just topped the Deep Root Champion. Yeah. I must have... I don't know. Either he has some busted cards or I got pinned. I mean, I guess, yeah. Probably has Hostage Taker. I mean, maybe the River Sneak is good. As I said, I haven't played Merfolk much. Seems not that great to me. It's uncommon. It's probably good in the Perfect deck, but he already, he's played three non-Merfolk creatures so far. Alright, dual shot, where are you? Dual shot in. What am I gonna board out? Interloper, maybe? I could board out a knight. Interloper. Could bring in Mark of the Vamp, but his deck doesn't seem like it hit as hard as the last guy we played against, so I think I can just play good solid magic and win. That's not ideal. So, Freebooter is really weird, because sometimes it looks like you miss, but really, you know, it shows you their hand first. I don't know why it does that. Pounce or New Horizon. So he gets to play Spy, then Pounce my guy, get back his New Horizon. I guess I'll take Pounce. And as usual, I bring in dual shots against the old one toughness guys, and it's looking like crap. I feel better about bringing in this deck though, because of the cutthroat guys, the four mana cutthroats. It's possible that I should maybe even main deck dual shot, because I have two of the assassins. Cutlass, not bad. Still haven't figured out how good Cutlass is. I'm not a huge fan. It's gonna be great in some decks. I saw Cedric Phillips won the PTQ, congrats to him. He's gonna be qualified for Bilbao, and they posted the lists, and he was playing two Cutlass in his Vamp deck. Which makes sense, you know, you have the lifelink guys, you have a lot of small creatures. So, you know, makes sense. But I don't think I've played Cutlass in a non-pirate deck so far. It's pretty hard. He's gonna play 6/6. I think I'm gonna lose this game. I drew one spell, I think, so far this game. Oh, wow. Wow. That was pretty good draw. Oh, Monstrosaur. Went from probably going to lose to can't possibly lose in one draw step. Alright, nice. Alright, let's see if I can get trophy number 15. Got paired against the champ, boys. The champ himself, trophy leader. Look at him, 47 trophies, a full 50% more than the guy in second place. He's not the champ for no reason. He beat me in a die roll. No secret. You don't get 47 trophies without winning your die rolls. I guess he mulliganed too, so now I'm just being a... I was already being an idiot. Alright, I have a pretty solid hand. Very good 6-card hand. And he's down to 5. I was like, probably finally gonna have a tough match. I guess first round was tough. Even second round, the second game, I was like one draw step away from losing. Being down 2 cards on the play is rough. Alright, he's... white black, most likely vamp. Wrecked. Oh God. That was me playing a bit too fast. That really sucks. Wow. Not playing my pirate pre-combat. Pretty awkward. All right. Maybe fine trading, you know, brute for... yeah, I'm just gonna take it. Definitely not fine trading brute for just the paladin. He's probably gonna attack. Yeah, he should be at 13. Hopefully he doesn't have another Deacon. Or, you know, Hydro Monstrous Ore. Interloper. Break. Land. Vampire Zeal. Oh, tricky. It's a good card. I know he has it if he keeps it, but... sometimes there's just nothing I can do about it. Alright, decides to bin it. Maybe he has another one. That'd be a semi blowout if he had another one. Oh no, he does. Ugh. think he's more likely to have another one in hand when he bins the first one. And now he can race. This 1-1 lifelink is really doing work. Not ideal, but I think I just have to block if Modo lets me. I'm gonna wait a bit because sometimes when Modo does that, like, I think he blocked, but he didn't really block. Probably gonna lose now. I need to draw a Montresor or Captivate. I need to draw one of my two bombs. Wow. It's beating me with old commons. Well, at least I don't feel too bad about my couple small mistakes. Doesn't look like it would have mattered. That's a mulligan to 5, by the way. Wow. Pretty perfect mulligan to 5, I guess, but mulligan to 5 nonetheless. Pretty impressive. Okay. Alright, Captivating Crew. He drew 9 lands. It's not like he drew like all spells. Just lifelink. Lifelink was too strong. Lifelink Cutlass. Maybe that's how he does it. That's how Seti P did it in the top 8 of the PTQ. Alright, he's trading? Probably has something in hand. Alright, let's see. Anything I can do about that. He didn't play too many removal spells. His deck is also, I feel, a bit clunky. I'm gonna try bringing in Raider's Wake. Does that make sense? Not sure. Pyromancer. So 0 removal spells. They're bringing the 1 mark of the vamp. Alright. Maybe knight is better than the 2-1. Given that he has a bunch of tokens. 2-2, almost vanilla over 2-1. That gives me a treasure. Pretty good. Most, you know, one of the most common removal spells is also Pious Interdiction, which is not great against Captivating Crew. Is Cutlass secretly a Vamp card and not a Pirate card? Oh, I mean, Sunrise, just great. First Strike. Love First Strike in the format. I mean, I could call. He could just attack, you know. He played 2 in game 1. But I feel like that's a bit dumb. You're probably supposed to block some amount of the time against a good player, especially after he showed 2. It's kind of tough. Alright. So I can gem mark up the vamp on my Captivating Crew, just literally move all in on the crew. And if he has anything, I lose. What did he hit? He kept Interloper. Could just Fire Cannon as Interloper. Or I could steal it, attack for 10. Puts him down to 7. Makes 2 of my guy lethal next turn if he ever taps out. Makes my Brute lethal. If he doesn't keep a blocker, 7. Gain control of target creature and open control. Alright, so let's say he has contract killing. He pretty much needs contract killing. If he had binding, he wouldn't have kept it. Oh wait, never mind. He binned the Interloper. Alright, that makes more sense. I was like, I'm dumb. Alright. So I can Fire Cannon Blast. I think that's the play. So Vamzeal, +2/+2 first strike. My guy has menace. So I could steal Paladin. Attack with everyone. Then he can Vamzeal his 1/1 lifelink. Or I could just attack with both. He's gonna block 3-2 on Captivating Crew. What if I see the Paladin? Attack with everyone. He's gonna block Vamp on the Captivating Crew. Give it +2/+2 for a strike. Have to use. What if I see the Lifelink token? I guess I'll just attack and use my cards. Alright, that's even better for me. I'm actually getting value now. Now I'm not getting value. He's at 10. Alright, I'm gonna sure strike my guy. Oh, he just didn't have it. Or maybe he knows I have another trick because he's dead good. Alright. Looks like he has. No, I mean, if he has Queenless Agent, he's just dead. What does he have? Alright, I'm gonna take it. What does he have? Removal spell? A Hammer Skull? Queen's Commission. Alright, he's just dead, right? Just vanquish the weak vamp, yeah. And just steal Hammer Skull. Still hasn't paid a removal spell. Oh no, I really want to bring in second Mark of the Vamp. To board out Raider's Wake, I'm gonna bring in Mark of the Vamp. The rest gets Queen's Commission, Cutlass, Vampire Zeal. It's kind of nice to see his hand. Maybe I'll bring in a Duress problem. He doesn't have that many spells. I feel like this Vampire Seed just owns me so hard. Let's see. Alright, the Hoarder is probably not great. Probably just want a Knight. Probably only keep 6/2 drops. I think that's a good number to have. Maybe a Brute on the draw. But Brute's probably my best target for Mark of the Vamp. Could bring in Dual Shot. I do have the 2 Cutthroats. Kind of want to bring in Dual Shot. Yeah, I'm not going to bring in the rest. And I think I'm only going to go with 1 Mark of the Vamp. Looks pretty good. Could make an argument for boarding out Unfriendly Fire maybe, because he didn't play any big guys. He does have the Queen Agent, I guess. hoping for a Raptor Companion, I guess, on turn two. No turn two. Ugh. Obviously an easy keep. I don't have black, I don't have a third land, but I've, you know, as good as it gets for two mountain hand. And I drew like a champ. Yeah. Empire Zeed's just so strong. Maybe I just attack for two, but then he's gonna block. And I get to dual shots. Oh, man, tough. I feel like Raptor is kind of short-sighted. It's good if he has nothing. I'll play a Brute. I'd be reasonable. I have a strong hand. I have a hand with a lot of value. I don't want to get blown out. I feel like if I don't spew my cards and don't get owned by his spells, his tricks, I'd probably be in reasonable shape. Just kept Vampire Zeal. Alright. So we know he has Zeal. I think I just play a Raptor and force a trade. He says no trade. Queen's Commission. Oh man, that dual shot might be really good. So if I play Freebooter, he depends. Well, I think it's pretty clear Freebooter. Because if he has multiple spells, he can't really afford to just play Vampire Zeal. Oh yeah, it's Slash as well. Ah, he has four spells in hand. They're all great. I guess I just take Vanquish, because Vanquish gets him his other spells back. Oh god. Wow. Alright, so let's see. If I take Vampire Zeal, I can attack with everyone. He's gonna slash my knight with the trigger on the stack. And then he's gonna either triple block my Brute or double block my Raptor. Then I dual shot, I get him, and then he vanquished the weak, gets back Vampire Zeal, and I'm back to square one. If I let him have Vamp Zeal, I can attack with everyone. I don't get wrecked too bad. I'm gonna lose a card to the... I also have Mark in hand and Captivating Crew. I can put Mark on my flyer, races pretty well. Yeah, I'm just gonna take Vanquish the Weak. Alright, can I attack? I think I can attack. I think I have to attack. I just have to make him use his cards, right? Slash, I mean, 1-for-1, can't do much about it. Vamzeal. I guess I'll make him use his cards. I don't think I can really get blown out. Man, that dual shot. Slash the raptor. Okay, I think my guy still gets +1/+1. Oh, okay. Might be good for me though. So I can kill his two, I can kill his lifelink guy, or I can kill his 1-3 flyer. Or I can kill them all. Basically trading I can either kill the 2/1/1s, he keeps his 1-3, I keep my 2/2. I can kill what, so basically what's more valuable, my 2/2 or his 1/1 lifelink? Given that he has Cutlass and Vamzeal, I think maybe he's. Yeah. Oh wait, that's not enough. 2 damage. Alright, never mind. So what's better? 1-3 flying or a 1-1 lifelink? 1-3 flying, 1-1 lifelink when he has Vamzeal in hand. I think the 1-1 lifelink is more valuable. I'm gonna kill the flyer. Eh. I'm gonna kill the lifelink dude, I guess. To draw land. This is not a land. Good bluff attack. But if he calls, if he blocks and pumps his guy, kind of screwed. He's gonna block 100. All right, I'm just gonna attack Wiz. The brute. What does he have? He's probably doing something else. Uh, Alright, I didn't draw land, but I drew something I can cast. And I do have been dead on board. If he doesn't have much. If he plays a Deacon, I think he's dead on board. Yeah. If he taps out for something that doesn't have lifelink, he's just dead on board. He's still dead on board? He might be. No, one short. Wow. He has one card. So he blocks the knight. Can put him down to one. And then I just die. Yes, I just have to keep my guys back. Keeping my guys back is not that bad. Alright. I'm still in pretty good shape. Five, yeah. I wonder if taking Vanquish the Weak was a mistake, because he never had time to cast it, but the game plays out differently if I don't take Vanquish the Weak. So, yeah. I'm in okay shape here. I can just double block his guy with First Strike. Just use Sure Strike. He can give it +2/+2, but it's not a Vamp, so it won't get First Strike from the Vampire Zeal. Plus this block doesn't look suspicious, that's how it'd block, you know, if I didn't have anything. Question is, do I use Sure Strike if he doesn't do anything? I think I do. Sure Strike, winning game. It's 2017. Game looking pretty good, not gonna lie. Alright, nice. Not sure I played that perfect. Freebooter play was kind of... Because, you know, it was like, he was kind of bottlenecked on mana, and if he uses free mana to vanquish the weak, a 1-2 flyer, the 1-2 flyer ended up doing nothing. Not really nothing, because he was there, he was threatening some damage, but not really. I guess he gave menace to my brute a bunch. Alright. You know, I had a great deck. Really good curve, solid removal, I had Captivating Crew as a bomb. Montrezor won me a, you know, game or two. Draft was pretty interesting, so I hope you guys enjoyed it, and good luck in your drafts. I'll see you guys next time.